The biggest nightmare regarding River Ruizi is here. Currently, people can cross on foot at ease. The river is piled with enough garbage to make a walkway. River Ruizi is losing its glory and has been heavily polluted. The river catchments have been completely degraded, riverbanks and shores destroyed. This has allowed quick movements of silt and soil sediments that have ended into the river. The river is a source of water for millions of people in 14 districts in western Uganda. Environmental experts warn that the river could soon die. Bamuteraki Tumusime, the chairman of the Ruizi Catchment Protection Committee, says if no quick interventions are made, the river may cease to exist in the next 5 to 10 years.
That is where you hear some of the rivers, some of the lakes being quoted as dead lakes, dead rivers. An example is this Lake Chad. Because of siltation, because of climate change, it lost all the water bodies. So this is what we call, in some years to come, the river would will be no more.
National Water has resorted to lowering the pumping machine so as to access water.
Now, the siltation, when you look at the siltation alone, it is taking over the wheat. The water is less and the water is finished. So our efforts also should look at various interventions in terms of restoring this. It's not only removing the weed, not only removing the rubbish, the bottles, and but other means of how we can restore the river. It should be our major concern. And in our previous meetings, we have been talking about this. We have been deliberating on how we can save our permanent source. And we are not giving up.
Experts explain that the soil sediments that keep depositing on the riverbed have created a slope of flow. This is why water flows fast.
One of the challenges we have, which was reflected earlier along, of poor catchment management. Whenever we receive rain, being in the source of the river in Kweshu, in Ntungama and Wampara, the water takes only 8 hours to have left. So what remains because of the turbidity and flow of the river is those depositions. And those are the depositions where you see that there is some little water flowing and you assume that the river has reached its highest water mark. But the percentage of it which you visualize is the soil sediments.
Residents worry that if drought persists for the next weeks, millions of people who get their water from River Ruizi face water shortage.
I'm standing in the middle of the river because if you see this side, the water was passing through the other side almost 20 meters from the river. But now you see even a 10-year kid can pass through using foot. So we fight this one, we call upon government to come and intervene immediately because otherwise things are going worse.
The laws in place, the NEMA Act is operational, but the whole challenge has been that a multi-sectoral approach where everybody should look at the environment as a threat. The only challenge is that they want to leave it for the technical team, the NEMA officials. But even the parish chiefs and sub-county chiefs and town agents, they have a role to play here.
River Ruizi, which covers approximately 8,000 kilometers, is located in Greater Ankole. The river is a source of water for both people and animals in over 10 districts of western Uganda. The river is served by many swamps, which serve as water catchment. Unfortunately, the majority of these swamps have been degraded and turned into gardens and farms for grazing animals. Report by Abdul Karim Singendo for the news.